Really preppy clothes, extreme preppy clothes. The visor, the Lacoste, the polos, Sperry's, khakis, party hardy, getting drunk.
Party boy, party animals.
Definitely like party animals.
Partying and drinking.
Movies. First image I think of is Animal House. Definitely. John Belushi in the college shirt with his, you know, drinking Jack Daniels and stuff. That's the first thought that comes to mind when I think of fraternity.
Tell you a story or two. Yeah, of course I learned some rules, like don't pass out with your shoes on, and don't leave the house till the booze gone, and don't have sex if she's too gone.
With more and more Hollywood films showing college fraternities as out-of-control partiers with hazing and alcohol problems, it is no surprise that new college students expect to see the same on their campuses. We asked the advisor for Appalachian State's Interfraternal Council about his thoughts on this image.
The movies obviously are like caricatures. They take truths and exaggerate them. And so movies like Animal House and Old School are not necessarily wholly inaccurate descriptions of Greek life, but they are widely exaggerated descriptions of Greek life. And so they set an expectation in the mind of the uninitiated or the non-college student who's maybe coming to campus for the first time. And so they think that's what Greek life is all about. And so if all they see is drinking, partying, hazing, those kinds of things, sort of general debauchery, if you will, and they're excited about that, then those folks are going to be the ones who come join. And so we're going to get students who want that kind of environment.
With Greek students in the minority at ASU, making up only 10% of the total student body, it is easy for negative Greek stereotypes to be perpetuated. We asked Aaron Bockenheimer how to change the public perception of college fraternities from partying to service and academic accomplishments.
I would tell somebody is, come out to some events. You know, come with me to some Greek Week events. Come with me to the Greek Leadership Conference. Come with me even to a tailgate atmosphere on a Saturday in the fall. Because even though that's a social environment, I think they'd see some fairly responsible young people having a great time supporting their university, enjoying brotherhood and sisterhood with each other, and I think have a different perspective. And so I think that's how you challenge stereotypes. It's not necessarily with a lot of information. It's getting people to meet people. What I hear oftentimes is somebody will say, gee, I didn't know he was Greek. Man, that's surprising to me. And it's surprising to them because they go, they know this person. They're like, he's a good student. He's a good person. You know, he treats me with dignity and respect. He likes to have a good time, but he does it in an appropriate way. And that somehow is counter to what they think of Greeks. And then you say, yeah, he's in a fraternity. And they're like, wow, that's surprising. And you can see the stereotype has been altered in their mind just by that experience.
I'm in a fraternity, Alpha Sigma Phi.
Why did you join?
Well, when I first got here, I didn't think I was going to join a fraternity. I just had negative stereotypes and all stuff. But then I got to know the people, got to know what they were actually about, what they were involved in, and I figured out the leadership positions and the charity events that I could be a part of.
What do you think of when you hear the word fraternity?
I think of a strong brotherhood that is willing to give back to the community.
All right. Where does this view come from?
comes from my personal experiences with the fraternity.
All right. Do you think Greek life is a positive force on campus?
I think it's a very positive force. I think that we help keep the community clean. We help charity events around here. Like, just the community in general is definitely, it's a very positive force on campus.